Today we are looking at extraction of iron. Now to extract iron, you are supposed to know the main ore and the other ore. Then you are supposed to know the extraction process. The extraction process include crushing of the ore, concentration of the ore, roasting of the ore, and then lastly reduction of the ore. Now the main ore for extraction of iron in its natural form is called hematite. The chemical name is called hydrated iron 3 oxide. The formula is that is the chemical name of hydrated iron 3 oxide. Now the other ores include in its natural form is siderite. The chemical name is iron 2 carbonate. The chemical formula is now the last type of ore we can also mention is called natural form is magnetite. The chemical name is triiron tetraoxide. Now the extraction process begins from one crushing of the ore. In here the ore is ground into fine powder so as to increase surface area for extraction of iron. Number two is concentration of the ore, whose aim is to remove the impurities. This is done by graphite separation process to remove earthly impurities like clay and sand. And then the washed ore is then subjected to electromagnetic separation, in which non-magnetic impurities is separated from magnetic. Number three is roasting of the ore. The concentrated ore is heated in the presence of excess air in shallow kilns. The aim is to make sure the entire mass of the ore become porous and suitable for reduction to metallic element in the blast furnace. The reaction of the roasting process occur as follows. There is the water of crystallization is removed as per the equation below. That is to say FeO2.3 water when it's heated. You lose this water here, you get iron 3 oxide plus 3 water. Now if there is a presence of siderite, which is iron 2 carbonate, iron 2 carbonate is decomposed to iron 2 oxide and carbon 4 oxide as shown in the equation. Iron carbonate solid gives you iron 2 oxide plus carbon 4 oxide gas. This is solid here. Now the iron 2 oxide formed is oxidized by atmospheric oxygen to form iron 3 oxides as shown in the equation below. You say iron 2 oxide solid plus oxygen gas gives you iron 3 oxide. To balance the equation, put here 2. That makes iron be 4, so you place here 4. Then oxygen, total number of oxygen is balanced because here is 2 times 3 is 6, and here is 4 plus 2, which also makes 6. After the roasting of the ore, the next stage is reduction of the ore. Reduction of the ore occurs in the blast furnace. The raw materials for the blast furnace are coke, limestone, iron 3 oxide, and blast air. The characteristics of the blast furnace is it is about 30 meters high. It's made of steel and the inner side is lined with fabrics made from magnesium oxide. So the diagram below shows blast furnace. The raw materials, you said this is made of steel, and on the inside here, on the inside, it is made of fire bricks made of magnesium oxides. The role of the fire bricks is to conserve heat energy in order to maintain optimum temperature required for reduction of iron 3 oxide. The raw materials end us from the top here, which you say it is limestone, cork, and iron 3 oxide. The blast air end us from this point here. The blast air end us at this point. Now, the reactions in the blast furnace occur in three stages. It starts from the base of the furnace, middle of the furnace, and the upper part of the furnace. So we're going to look at the reaction at the bottom of the furnace. The cork, which is the raw material, is oxidized by blast air to form carbon 4 oxide. Now, because the reaction is exothermic, it raises the temperature at this part of the furnace to about 1000 degrees Celsius. The reaction, the equation for the reaction is carbon plus oxygen, RO, gives you carbon 4 oxide, as shown below. Say carbon solid plus oxygen gas gives you CO2 gas. The enthalpy change is negative 393 kilojoules per mole. That is negative enthalpy change, means the reaction is exothermic. Now, in the middle part of the furnace, the carbon 4 oxide formed at the bottom of the furnace is reduced by cork to form carbon 2 oxide. Since the reaction is endothermic, the temperature drops to 1000 degrees Celsius. So the temperature in the middle part of the furnace here becomes 1000 degrees Celsius. So the equation of the reaction is carbon 2 oxide plus carbon gives you carbon 2 oxide. The equation for the reaction occurs as follows. It says CO2 gas plus cork gives you CO gas. The balance equation I place there too. The enthalpy change here is plus 283 kilojoules per mole. The positive enthalpy change means the reaction is endothermic. Now, other reactions that occur in the middle of the furnace include limestone, which is a raw material, decomposes to form calcium oxide and carbon 4 oxide. The equation is as follows. You say calcium carbonate, RO, calcium oxide plus carbon 4 oxide. Chemical equation becomes calcium carbonate solid, it is heated here, it gives you calcium oxide solid plus carbon 4 oxide gas. Now the calcium oxide formed reacts with the impurities in the ore, which was silicon 4 oxide and aluminium oxide, to form calcium silicates and calcium aluminate respectively. The equations for the reaction are as follows. Calcium oxide plus silicon 4 oxide, RO, gives you calcium silicates. So you say here calcium oxide solid plus silicon 4 oxide, which is a solid, gives you calcium silicate liquid. Now, the other reaction is calcium oxide plus aluminium oxide gives you RO calcium aluminate. The reaction occurs as follows: calcium oxide plus aluminium oxide solid RO gives you calcium aluminate liquid. Now the two compounds form what we call slag. Slag is tapped off at the eye level because it has low density and it is immiscible with iron. Now in the upper part of the furnace, the iron 3 oxide is reduced by the main reducing agent, which is carbon 2 oxide, to form iron. The reaction occurs as follows: carbon 2 oxide plus iron 3 oxide, RO, iron plus carbon 4 oxide. The chemical equation is carbon 2 oxide plus iron 3 oxide solid gives you iron solid plus carbon 4 oxide. And the iron obtained, now the iron formed here is tapped here. So we remove iron here, then we remove slag at this point here. Then this reaction occur in the upper part of the furnace here, where it occurs at temperature about 700 degrees Celsius. Now the waste gases from this extraction of iron are removed at this point here, which includes nitrogen 4 oxide, nitrogen, carbon 2 oxide and carbon 4 oxide. Now it is necessary to recycle carbon 4 oxide. So as now the iron obtained from this process is impure. The iron obtained from the blast furnace is 90-94% pure, and therefore is called pig iron. The main impurities in iron are carbon, silicon, manganese oxide, sulfur, and phosphorus. The effects of impurities on iron: it makes it less hard, it makes it brittle, and then it lowers the melting point of iron. Now, if you're told to explain how carbon can be removed, you say the iron, the metal obtained is oxidized in air, where carbon reacts with oxygen to form carbon 4 oxide. The importance of slag from this process: it can be used in manufacture of building materials, manufacture of cements, and is also used in road making. Thank you, learners. That's the end of the lesson. The next lesson we're going to look at extraction of copper.